All right, welcome to Dental Board Exam Review. So today we're going to go through dental impression materials. This is a review of some of the high-heeled materials. If you'd like to review the full lecture, it's available online, and this is only available to subscribed students who are having tutorials for national boards, okay? But this is a review of some of the impression materials based on some of the people who have requested this material, okay? So it should guide you and help you in terms of memorizing certain properties of some of the materials that we use. All right. Okay, so moving forward, so alginate, so the accurate alginate impressions require what? Okay, so here you have to know the alginate, which is one of the most common impression materials. You should know the properties of alginate before you take this exam, okay? Also, the most important one is also you have to know that some of the formula, okay? Alginate, the properties that we are going to discuss after this question. So let's see what this question is. So accurate alginate impression material require what? So does it require the fit and modification of the stock tray? Is it the variation in water powder ratio to alter the setting time? Increase in water temperature to improve setting expansion? Vacuum mix to improve the tear strength of the material, or is it B and C? Okay. So when I created this question, pretty much just to confuse you, I put B and C, but here the answer is actually A. Okay, so A is the answer, is the accurate fit and modification of stroke tray. Okay, so you need, because if you don't have a proper tray which is going to allow the proper thickness of material, so you won't have an accurate impression. So sometimes you need to modify the tray, okay, for accuracy. All right, so what is alginate? So some of the properties of alginate. So now I put dental alginate here because there are a lot of alginates used in dermatology, alginates used in orthopedics, okay? But so dental alginate is called irreversible hydrocolloid, okay? There is also a hydrocolloid which you can reverse, okay? But alginate is irreversible hydrocolloid. So meaning, when you look at the formula, when you add water, it's going to harden and you cannot reverse that that reaction, okay? So alginate can be easily measured, okay? They are aesthetic in appearance. Some alginates are white, but some of them have been they give them color, like pink. Okay, they have a pleasant odor. They are easy to handle, and they are very low cost. Okay, and because they are very low cost, most people use them because of the economic factor of it. They are, however, they have very poor dimensional stability, which is time dependent. Okay, so the longer it takes, the more the higher the chances of inaccuracies. So when you take it, you're supposed to pour into stone within 10 to 12 minutes. Okay, so For these reasons, alginates have been considered reasonably satisfactory substitutes, okay, for agar. So agar, A-G-A-R, those were some of the initial impression materials, okay? Agar, wax, all those were used for impression until the alginate came in, okay? But when the alginate came in, agar went out of fashion, okay? And because of it, it's cheap, okay? It has pleasant odor, all this, so it has replaced agar. However, they have disadvantages that make them less desirable than agar. For example, the material is not as accurate, okay, and does not produce fine detail when you compare to other impression materials, okay? So alginate is good, it's cheap, easy to use. However, it is not accurate and does not give fine detail of the impression, okay? So you can use this alginate to take preliminary impressions, for example, removal of partial dentures. However, you cannot use them for final impressions, okay? So the just to summarize in terms of the important points. So alginate impression materials can be used for full arch impressions, okay, because of low cost and good wetting properties, meaning it can be mixed with saliva with no issues, and it's a popular choice for diagnostic casts, okay? You can use alginate to take diagnostic, which is a preliminary impressions, but you cannot use them for final impressions, okay? They can also be used, okay, for impression for partial removable denture prosthesis, okay? They are considered hydrophilic in nature. It allows it to be used in the presence of saliva and blood. However, it has very poor dimensional stability because of loss of water creates distortion, okay? Loss of water, due to evaporation, and also it can expand when it absorbs water. So imbibition is another problem with alginate, okay? So to avoid all those problems, you have to pour alginate within 10 minutes. Okay, 10 to 12 minutes is the usual time. So the other property of alginate is that the accuracy, okay, is not affected by the consistency of the mix. So if you put too much water, the accuracy is not going to be, or the setting is not going to be affected. However, the setting time is affected by the temperature. If you use hot water, the reaction is going to be accelerated, so it's going to be fast. It's going to set very fast. If you use cold water, like freezing water, the setting time is going to be longer. Keep that in mind, okay? So make sure that before you use water, you mix. Make sure you feel it for the temperature, whether it's hot or cold. All right. So the next material that we're going to discuss here is going to be PVS, okay? Polyvinyl siloxane. Polyvinyl siloxane is also known as additional silicone. All right, this is part of elastomeric impression material. So, question: the purpose of refrigerating PVS impression material is what? What is the reason that you put PVS impression material? A. Decrease setting time. B. Decrease working time. C. Decrease both working and setting time. D. Increase both working and setting time. Okay. So refrigerating. Remember, refrigerating. I just told you that with alginate, you have for it to be longer, you have to use cold water. Okay. It takes longer to set, to harden. Okay. However, if you use hot water, it's going to, the alginate is going to take a very short time before it hardens, before it sets. Okay. So the PVS is also similar. If you want it to last longer, to take longer, to give you more working time, you have to use to refrigerate it. Okay. You have to put in a refrigerator to cool it down, okay, so that way the reaction is slow, so the setting time is slow, the time that it gets hard is slower, so it gives you more time to work with the patient, to work with the material, okay. Now, which is the reason why the PVS, you don't mix it with water. Okay, if you had to mix with water, probably it will have the same effect. But because you don't mix with water, for you to have a little bit longer working time and setting time, you put it in the fridge. Okay. So our answer here is D. Okay, D is the answer. And so PVS. Okay, let's discuss some of the elastomeric impression materials. So elastomeric impression materials, okay. So alginate, okay. There's alginate, which is mostly related to calcium. Then you have elastomeric materials. So elastomeric meaning materials which are elastic, okay. They are elastic, meric. They are also polymers. Okay. They are polymers. Now, and they were developed because as dentists, we don't usually pour impressions immediately. We take impression and then there's something else that we have to do. So you put the impression on the side. If you do this with alginate, some people put it like a wet towel over it. But the problem with putting a wet towel over it, sometimes the towel gets dry and the alginate get dry, lose water, or sometimes the alginate will absorb the moisture in the towel. So the accuracy is affected. But because we don't pour them immediately, so companies have developed the materials which last a little bit longer to give us time, okay, before we pour them. So elastomeric materials are good to give us time. So elastomeric materials, you have polyethers, okay, and then you also have polysulfide rubbers. You have additional silicone rubbers, okay, which is PVS, all right, and you also have silicone polymers, which are condensation silicones, okay. So you have to know all four of them, all right? You have to know the alginate, you have to know the PVS, you have to know the polyethers, polysulfides, okay? Before you go in your exam, all right? So because these are rubber-like materials, they are very soft, rubber-like, they can be easily stretched, okay? They are able to return to relaxed state when you put stress on them, so they have some dimensional stability. Okay, so let's look at PVS. So PVS is also called additional silicone. Okay, it is not a condensation silicone; it is an additional silicon. So you have to pay attention. All right, additional silicon. So usually it comes in two. You have to mix it. Okay. You have two polymers that you mix. Sometimes you mix two parties in your hands. Some of you who are in dental school, you are using the material, and some of you have been practicing for a while. You have used some of this material, but sometimes, you know, you can practice, you know the material, how to mix it, so, but you have to review the details of the properties, okay, of this material. And there's a party, you mix two parties, and then you put in the patient's mouth. Some of it comes with a syringe with two tubes, and then as you push through the syringe, it mixes, okay? So you have two polymers which are added together. So it's PVS is an additional silicone. So they are available in a variety of viscosity. You can have like a light body, you have a medium body, you have a heavy body. For example, if your PVS is very good, if you're taking like a crown impression and you want to capture all the outline, the shoulders or the chamfer, or you know, the margins, you want to capture very nice margins, so you can put, for example, a light body material, which is going to a light body because it's very light, it's going to flow all those areas and capture the form. And then light body, you just put a little bit right over your preparation of the crown or crown prep, or if you're preparing whatever you're preparing, you put the light body, and then after that you put a medium body or heavy body, okay, to capture the rest of the teeth and occlusion, okay? So they have high elasticity, so they have high elastic modulus, and their stiffness makes them an ideal material for implant prosthesis. So these are good for implants. You can also, as I mentioned, use for crowns. Excellent physical properties, dimensional stability, and handling characteristics. You can put in your hand, play it, it's like a Play-Doh, okay? So going back, so there's a chemical reaction of PVS, okay? Or additional silicone involves a base paste. I told you have to have two polymers that you mix. A base paste which contains hydroxylene, okay? Molecules, which reacts with an accelerator paste containing siloxane, okay? So siloxane, these two, hydroxylene and siloxane polymers are going to be catalyzed by platinum. Remember that, okay? So the catalyst in this additional silicon, the reaction is platinum. And platinum, when you do this reaction, is going to produce hydrogen as a byproduct. And because that hydrogen byproduct, then it's going to form bubbles. All right. So if you pour your stone immediately, some of this, if the reaction has not completed, the hydrogen is going to form bubbles on your stone. So that's why sometimes when you pour the stone and it's too early, you pour it too soon, sometimes you see like a small bubbles on your stone, okay? And that makes the impression ugly. And if it's on the occlusal surfaces that you are interested in, then it makes it more inaccurate. So that's coming from the reaction with platinum, all right? So you have to keep that in mind, okay? All right. So some of the, just to mention about additional silicones here, so that's polyethers, which we'll be discussing. So let's go back to PVS here. So the PVS, they like, it's very good material. When you go to a lot of offices, they use PVS, okay? So the additional reaction silicon rubbers. They have excellent physical properties, dimensional stability, as I mentioned earlier, and the materials also, they have outstanding accuracy, okay? PVS can last about a week, so you have a week to pour it, okay? That's another thing you have to know. So, and I think that those are favorite questions. It can take about a week, okay? Before you pour it. After a week, you start losing some accuracies, okay? So the material has outstanding accuracy. It is capable of recording fine details, okay? Compared to alginate, which cannot record fine details. And it is elastic, and so it can be easily removed from the undercuts because it's elastic, all right? It's also clean, another advantage, they are clean, okay? They are clean, they are odorless, okay? And they are tasteless, all right? And because of its exceptional dimensional stability, additional silicones, also remember additional silicones are PVS, can be poured at the convenience of the dentist, okay? The handling characteristics of PVS are enhanced by the fact that silicones are available in different viscosities, as I mentioned, in medium body, hard body, or light body. Okay. However, another disadvantage of PVS, which you have to keep in mind, is that the accuracy is affected by latex, okay? Latex gloves. So the polymerization of PVS is affected by latex gloves. So make sure that you don't use latex gloves when you're using this material, okay? So no latex with PVS because polymerization is affected or inhibited, okay? So use non-latex gloves, okay? I mentioned earlier about another point to remind you is that to increase the working time or the setting time, you can put the material in the fridge, but this gives you like an additional 1 minute of working time, okay? And putting in the fridge does not affect the accuracy of the material, all right? Keep that in mind. Also, another important point about PVS or additional silicone is that, as I mentioned, so whenever I repeat things, remember, those are very important points for you to remember, is that PVS produces hydrogen, okay, which can increase bubbles or pitting of the cast, okay? All right. Sometimes, depending on your tray, okay, sometimes the PVS, if you use a tray which has perforations, sometimes the PVS material needs, you need to use like an adhesive on the tray so that when you take it out of the mouth, the tray doesn't come off the material, okay? Sometimes, but however, this you can use trays which are perforated so that it goes into the undercut of the tray. So sometimes you don't have to use adhesive, okay? All right, so let's discuss polyethers. So the question is, when I made this question was just to make sure that you know, which of the following impression material is too stiff, okay, to be used in undercuts? So if you didn't have the topic here as polyethers, then you choose, okay? But here we already know that it's going to be polyethers, all right, based on the topic, all right? So the answer here is, of course, C. So now, polyethers are very stiff. They cannot be used in undercut areas. So you must block them, okay? Must block undercuts when you use polyethers, okay? Otherwise, you are going to be stuck. It's going to be uncomfortable to removing the impression from the patient's mouth, especially if the patient has like a bridge and the material goes under the pontic, and you're trying to remove it. It's miserable. You know, you can actually pull out the bridge, okay, if the patient has periodontal disease. So remember, polyethers, PVS, or the elastomeric material, when you're about to use them, make sure that the patient doesn't have periodontal disease. Otherwise, you may extract it. I remember when we were in dental school, one of my classmates, forgot to tell the patient because trying to take impression and removing the impression material, it ended up extracting the tooth. Okay. So you have to tell the patient that, look, this teeth are loose. We're about to take this impression, you know, and prepare the patient that the teeth may be extracted if they are periodontal involved. Otherwise, if you can try to remove the impression early before it completely sets, but then again, that's going to affect some of your accuracies, okay? So keep that in mind. Don't use PVS or polyethers if the teeth are very loose. That goes for anything, actually. So just keep in mind of the periodontal disease of the patient, periodontal disease status. All right, so polyethers are most accurate, okay? They are the most, I repeat that, they are the most accurate and dimensionally stable of all the elastomeric impression materials, okay? So you have to keep that in mind. Polyethers are the most accurate and dimensionally stable, all right? They have excellent accuracy of the accuracy compared to alginate and PVS, along with dimensional stability, okay? Very excellent dimensional stability. They are also easy to handle. They have extended shelf life, okay? And you have accepted odor, okay? Even though, so the PVS is odorless, but the polyethers have some odor to them. Patient acceptance is a very attractive feature for the clinician also, all right? So they have, they are very popular because of they have a fast setup time. They are easy to clean up, and they have very good patient acceptance. Remember that. They are the most accurate, okay? And polyethers also, they make the cast more accurate because the rate, okay, and the degree of polymerization that they have. They don't undergo continuous polymerization, okay, after you remove them from the mouth. So that contributes to stability, okay? When you compare, as I told you, with the PVS, you can put it in the mouth, you remove it, but because of the catalyst, okay, it continues to produce hydrogen, okay? So if you pour PVS, it forms bubbles or pitting on the cast. Okay, because of the hydrogen. All right. However, polyethers, the good thing is that once you remove them outside the mouth, they are stable. Okay, the reaction, that the polymerization reaction does not continue. This prevents shrinkage, okay, and increases dimensional stability. Another advantage of polyethers is that they have no byproduct. for PVS or additional silicon, you produce hydrogen, okay? Polymers, polyethers, you don't use, you don't have any byproducts, okay? So that's very good. Condensation silicons, okay, hence the name, they produce water, okay? However, remember, polyethers don't produce any byproducts. That's another advantage, okay? The accuracy of the impression is usually long lasting, so you can pour it after 1 week, okay? I usually give it a week, but you can pour it after 1 week, you still have some good accuracy. All right. And so, because the material has a high degree of dimensional stability, polyethers do not have to be poured immediately after mixing, and they can be sent safely to a laboratory, okay, without fear of time-dependent dimensional change. So you don't have to. Sometimes it's, after a week, for example, you have PVS, and after a week you're like, oh, I need to send this to the lab quickly. So you're worried that the dimensional stability is going to change. However, polyethers are long-lasting. You don't have to worry about that, okay? So, to give you the comparison of time of stability, so alginate, you have to pour it within 10 to 12 minutes. PVS, you have to pour it within 1 week, okay? Polyethers, you can wait a little bit longer than 1 week, okay? So those are advantages. Now, you can store polyethers for a long time, okay? Before you mix them or you pour them. However, because of their hydrophilic properties, you have to store in a place which is not moist, okay? Otherwise, they're going to absorb that moisture. All right, so keep that in mind. All right, the next subject that you have to know. So we have discussed alginate, we have discussed the PVS, which is an additional silicon. We have discussed polyethers. Now there's other impression materials, which is polysulfides and condensation silicons, which is available from the dental board or D board exams. Okay, if you have any questions or you need to tutorial in certain areas, or you need a complete lecture, okay, which is available to those of you who are taking the course, it's available to you, okay. If you want to obtain this, you have to register for the course, okay? For the courses for the national boards. This is not for national boards part two. If you're taking part one, of course, keep that in mind that this course is available when you're ready to take your part two boards, okay? Now, the problem is that this actually, if you are going to take this exam after 2019, what's going to happen is that You need to incorporate this material now in your studying. If you're studying for part one and part two, everything's together because it's integrated. So whether you're taking part one or part two, this lecture is going to be good for you because everything's going to be integrated. Okay. All right. So I recommend for some of you, I recommend that you just take your part one and then part two before everything is integrated, because I think it's going to be harder. It's going to be harder trying to prepare for the clinical part and for the preclinical part. Okay, you have the sciences and the clinical factors, everything together. Okay. All right. So as a bonus here, let's review some of just a question on irreversible hydrocolloids. Okay. So what is irreversible hydrocolloid? Remember, I told you, irreversible hydrocolloid, we discussed this. So the question is, which of the following is not an acceptable final impression material? Is it polysulfides, which are polysulfides, which we haven't discussed, but is available to the to those of you who have registered for the course or and taking the course, okay? Is it additional silicones we have discussed in this review here? Polyethers we have discussed, and irreversible hydrocolloids, okay? So what is the answer here? So the answer here is irreversible hydrocolloid, because the topic is irreversible hydrocolloid. So what is irreversible hydrocolloid? It is alginate, okay? And alginate is not used for final impressions, okay? So do not use alginate for final impressions. I know sometimes there are some companies make more like they're trying to increase the stability and the accuracy of the alginate, but mostly for the purpose of this exam, you don't use alginate for final impressions, okay? You can use it for diagnostic cast, but don't use it for final casts, okay? All right, if you have any questions, you have the email here, which is dentalboard, okay, at dboardexams.com, all right? For those of you taking the course, this the complete lecture of this is available to you, okay? All right, so good luck. If you have any questions, please go ahead and email, and we'll be happy to answer your questions. For those of you waiting for the future videos, go ahead and subscribe, okay? Good luck and enjoy your weekend. Or enjoy the rest of the week.